So friends, today in this video, I'm going to tell you how to create a table and database in MySQL Workbench. So we have used MySQL in command prompt or CMD. Now we are going to use MySQL in Workbench. So when you open the MySQL Workbench, now this interface will appear. Now you have to click on this local instance MySQL ET. Just click on it. After this, you have to enter the password that you have used while installation. So just my password was, I have recently changed my password. And if you want to know how to change the password, you can find the link in the description where I have to give a short demo how can you do that. So we can save it as a vault in vault right now. So yeah, this is our interface now, and these are our database. Fine. So if you want to create a database here, so first of all, guys, you must know that database is known as schemas in Workbench. If you want to create a database here, you have to click on this option, create a new schema. And when we click on it, now we have to name it here. So I'm going to name it MySQL Tut. Fine. And I'm going to apply here. So the server is configured with the load. Okay, so I have to use load word. So yeah, this is now. So just click on apply. So now you can see that we have created our database MySQL Tut. So you have to use the smallest letter to create. So by default it is used in a smallest letter. So now to create a new table, what you have to do, you have to select, or you can right click on it and create table. Click on create table. Now you have to name the table here. So first of all, suppose I'm going to create a table student. Fine. And after that, and after this, we have to go to this column name. So you have to click on this and double click on it, so this text box will be appear. So now we can start with serial number. Fine. And this will be in type, and we can use set it as primary key. So primary key is used for unique, and this will be unique. Fine. And not null. And after that, we are going to create our second column. Double click on it and just type first name, and it is set as by default varchar 45, or we can just remove the space. And now we are going to set it as not null. Fine. And after that, the third column will be, so just similarly we can create more one by one columns of our table. So it's like last name. Fine, last name, and it is also should be, it can be null, not null, it can be null basically. And after the third one should be roll number, and I have to change it to integer. Where is integer? And it cannot be not null, as well as it should be primary key. And after that, primary key is basically the unique, and it should be unique. So roll number should be usually unique. So yeah, that's why we are using it. Now what can, yeah, we can add gender here, and gender should be gender should be one character. I can use char here, and it cannot be not null. Could not be set a new data type. So right now it is not allowing me. So let it be var char and just keep the not null, because gender cannot be not null. Fine. And after this, I think we have done so far. Now we can apply these settings to our table and just save it. Just apply it. So when you click on apply, it will configure with this, and these changes will be appear to the object. Now this query will be executed since we have created table, and this query will if you want to create a table, we can execute this table, this query, or we can do by this method that allowed by Workbench. So Workbench has a definitely advantage in MySQL, because it makes our task very easy. Just click on apply and it will execute the SQL statement. When we have done it in the CMD command prompt, we have to execute all the commands or queries. So yeah, I think we have created our table here. Now let me close this. Now guys, we are going to print our table, so we can basically, where are the columns? So yeah, we have to use one query here. We are going to run first query here to print our table. Asterisk is used for all rows, and from table name is student, and just semicolon, and we are going to run this query. So click on this lightning, or we can say what is the sign. This is used to execute our query. Click on it and you can see this is right now our table, and which is a null empty table. So we are going to add entries here. So first of all, one serial number, and this is first name is Manish, second name is Patel, roll number is 2 or 58. Let me put 58 here, and gender is male. Second is 2, and first name is Anand, second is Kumar, roll number is 13, and gender is male. Now again, third, Chetan Sharma, roll number is 48, and this is also male. And one more, 4, and I should Anjali, one name should be female, so Anjali Kumar, or roll number is 23, and she is female. Fine. This is our table. We need to click on apply to apply this query. So now these query will be executed. So just click on apply and now click on finish. Fine. So this is our table now. If I just close it, or just close it, this window, if I run this command again, now you will see this is our table actually. Fine. This is our table actually in our database, which is MySQL Tut, we have recently created. So what can we do more in this? So we have created our database, which is our schemas in Workbench. Now we have created a table. Now what can we do more? So we are going to apply some queries here. So first of all, let me do some operation So what can I do? Yeah, so let me run some query here. Select first name, last name from student where gender is actually male. Fine. And this is our query. Just put the semicolon and I'm going to run the command. Fine. So it will actually print the first name and last name where the gender is male. Where the gender is male, basically the boy student, boy the student will be print here. So let me click on this. And as you can see, the output is Manish Patel, Anand Kumar and Chetan Sharma. If I put F here, so it will print the female one. So just click on it and you can see Anjali Kumar. So you can select any of the column, any of the row accordingly after applying the conditions, and yeah, that's how you can do it in Workbench. I hope you like it. I hope you understood. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. And this is it. I hope you enjoyed the video. See you in the next video. Till then, bye.